Now, this is the infamous Ken Flynn. Ken, great to see you. How does it feel to be here tonight?
It's amazing to be here after 50 years. I thought we might be, thought I might be dead at this stage, but it is fantastic to be still here and meet so many good old mates. It's just
and
wonderful.
Do you remember David Greer or Stuart Matthews or the Coen twins, maybe? Oh, Gwenda Saul?
I particularly remember the Coen twins.
You do?
In my first year, I remember Ida and Julie sat in the front row and the teachers couldn't distinguish one from the other. But they divided them and put one at the back of the room and the other at the front of the room. So there were Julie at one end and Ida was at the other end.
And what would you like to say to them now?
I'm sorry they didn't run away with me. It's a pair of them.
You're going to just say hello to David Greer.
Hello to David Greer.
Yeah.
Oh, hello David. Hello, David. Hello, David. Hello, David. I hope you're very well.
And what are your closing words,
John, are you ready
to David and Stuart right now?
Never forget where you're not only born, but where you're educated. Wesley College, the very best. And also just to say to you, both of you, the school itself, or the college itself, is in very good shape. Nearly 900 people there, including 100 boarders, and with excellent principal, who knows what he's doing and is getting further along. And Arthur here is trying to put me off now, but I'm not ignoring him completely.
Fantastic. there is a waiter. Oh.
Very good, Billy. I enjoyed that. Tell Laura I love her. Tell Laura I need her.
Tell Laura not to cry. My love for her will never die.
You'll be a bachelor boy, and that's the way you stay.
Up in 1B, do you remember? Remember you had to say them all up in 1B.
We had a sort of a free chat session up there.
Every night, each and every night, well, oops and daisy, how you drove me crazy. Well, I guess it doesn't matter anymore. There's no use in me, I'm crying, I've done all I can, and now I'm sick of crying, I'm closing my eyes, wasted all my days over you.
Well, here we are in Enniscorthy on the banks of the lovely Slaney River, and in front here is Douglas Armstrong. Douglas started in the same year. I think he started in A upper, or I think I started A lower, or very, very lower, much lower. Anyway, Douglas, will you give us some of your thoughts and reminiscences about, first of all, Burlington and then Wesley. So away you go.
Well, Burlington, my main memories of Burlington were that breakfast down below in the basement, charging you to get ready to walk in line, the Willie Devers marching smartly beside us down Eastern Street, and then getting back and being able to go out into the garden and kick a football around as much as possible.
Do you remember the croquet as well too on the lawn?
Gosh, that was...
Yeah?
That was very occasional though.
When the weather committed.
And then, I cannot remember why we should go into Tullamaine every so often. Was it? I think it would have been for tennis or something.
Do you remember we had the gym in Tullamaine, do you remember? And Sergeant Major Hastings.
Oh, I remember Sergeant Major Hastings because... But more particularly in the gym up in Wesley, whenever we went up there. And that parallel bar, or that gym bar that was sort of offset, there was a metal pipe coming up which used to get in the way of our five-a-side football in the gym. And the dust down there when we played five-a-side or tip rugby down the gym.
Well, I can remember your brother. You used to play with a tennis ball in between the break or something like that in study. Oh, and soccer with a tennis ball.
Yeah. I remember playing tip rugby out in the yard.
Yeah.
Well, before the yard was tarmacked, which was at the very end, I think, with a rolled up jotter with a piece of string tied around it. And playing out in the Hamburg Alley with the tennis rackets.
Jimmy, to interrupt here, In Wesley, of course, we had Willie. In Burlington, we had Willie Devers, who was good. He was actually a very nice housemaster. His bark was worse than his bite. I always thought that about Willie. But also, we had Ernie Armitage. And if you were to see Ernie Armitage today, you wouldn't believe it. He just hardly aged at all. I call him Peter Pan. He's incredibly well preserved, and a lovely assistant housemaster to Willie.
Yes, of course, these people that we felt were old then were probably only in their late 20s, early 30s, which is not a huge gap. But then there were. Remember Miss Smith over in Tullamaine, our French teacher in early first year. First year and second year. And then the older Mrs. Smith, or Miss Smith. Were they both Miss or Mrs.?
I think they were both Miss. So in today we would refer to them as Ms. Smith, wouldn't we? Being politically correct.
The other Miss Smith. In Epworth,
yes. Yeah. You know that now is where we have our dinner, our past pupils' dinner now. It's the tennis, Fitzwilliam Lawn Tennis Club. So it's actually situated on the site of Epworth.
Whenever you think of the grounds that Wesley had and what they would have been valued at 5 years ago or 7 years ago, the Tullamaine areas, Epworth, Burlington, and Wesley itself, of course. Although that was a very enclosed sort of space. They sold, but the.
What do you think of the new college?
Very well out of it at the time.
Yeah. It enabled them to build the new, to go out onto the campus in Ballantyre. And it's in a lovely location looking, you've got the Dublin Mountains there, just under the Dublin Mountains, and it's certainly very scenic. I think they need to spend a little bit of money on the windows and what have you. The insulation, needs to be upgraded a bit.
Current standards.
Exactly, yeah. But nevertheless, a beautiful site for a college, for a school, campus style.
What I was a bit sorry about was that whenever they sold college, I didn't get around there in time because under one of the granite stained glass windows, my father had carved his initials. At the very back of the entrance hall was the stained glass, and at the back of that out into the yard, my father had inscribed his name in the granite.
Do you know where that stained glass window is now?
No.
It's in Methodist College, Belfast.
Yes.
If you visit Methody, I'm sure they'd show you the that window. Was it the Crook Memorial window, I think?
I wonder would the granite have gone with it.
No, I don't think so. I don't think the scratch marks.
Although the grounds would have been shaped.
So there you are. Just to see if you can get behind the window, and you might see your father's signature. Look, they've all sorts of strange things. They've got the past pupils board, you know, roll of honour for people who died in two world wars. Well, there was a name there on it, and this guy walked in off the street, looked at it, and said, "Look, I'm not dead. My name shouldn't be on this roll of honour." So apparently, I don't know. It's still on it, and it's a famous. I'm sure he's still alive because that was only a few years ago. But certainly, it's one of the things to remember when you're going into Methodist in the front door. Okay. So you get looking for that that bit of granite and see if you can find your father's initial. Anyway, I'll tell you what we're going to do now. I'm just going to sort of rest here for a second, and you can give us an indication of, you know, what you've been doing yourself for the last 50 years since you left.
Right. Well, the year I left school, I then went to sea for a year because I was told that I was probably a bit immature to go to Trinity. So I joined Irish Shipping as a cadet deck officer and had a few trips over to the States, and on the last trip I stayed for about 3 months and came back on another ship. So that was a good gap year, as they'd call it now. And then went to Trinity to do business studies. Unfortunately, my social life, snooker in the Hist and the Phil, and many hours spent in the Scotch House, it's not conducive to a good degree. And I failed my second year and promptly had to rethink my whole future. As the family was in the food business, mainly wholesale, back here in Enniscorthy, I decided to join a company over in England in the supermarket business, Finefare, and worked for a year and a bit in Cooper's in Knightsbridge, which was one of their flagship stores, before joining the Nestlé company, initially as a salesperson, but then in marketing in their head office in Croydon, during which time I met a English lady and we got married. And whilst still working with Nestlé, a friend of mine had started a business doing sports surfacing and marking of sports courts for three local authorities, Kent, Surrey and Sussex schools, and was looking for somebody to give him a hand in managing it. And I left Nestlé and joined him, and we developed the business quite rapidly and successfully, but the sports side developed rather more and I was involved in that, and I seemed to be spending more and more of my time in the Middle East, which didn't go down terribly well with the family. And decided at that time the Irish government was starting to spend a bit of more money on sports facilities in schools and around the country in sports for the community. So I decided to break with the company in England and come back over here and start my own business, which I did in 1980. But no sooner had I come back than the government decided the money is all gone. And so I kept going, but never really developed the business as much as I thought it was originally going to be. Had ups and downs, but I'm still alive, still plodding away with line marking, sports surfaces, and for quite a few years during the boom times, we were doing hardwood floors in private houses, but it's dance floors and sports floors really. In the name. And that's where I am today, still.
Well, you survived the years very well. The 50 years, you took an awful lot less than 70. The age we're all heading for, you know, the famous, infamous. And after that, everything is a bonus. But looks like you're going to get quite a bit of a bonus. Anyway, listen, it's lovely. It's a lovely part of the world here in Enniscorthy, and there's a lovely path here, and it's a very nice hotel in the background. So we'll just stop it there. Anything else you'd like to say to any of your schoolmates that are going to be listening to this?
Just that I've got very fun memories. I enjoyed my time. Some people really didn't like school, particularly boarding school. Right, there are times whenever I didn't enjoy it, but I look back on it very fondly for the friendships I made. Right, I haven't kept them up, but I still think of people fondly.
the camaraderie. I was always keen on kicking a ball around. I was no great shakes at it, but I enjoyed it. And my chief memories, to be honest, of school were play times, break times, either five aside and that sort of thing. Dashing out after meals to get out of the yard quickly, and we never had an idle moment, really. And I would recommend it to anybody.
Anyway, I tell you this, any of our functions in future, you're certainly going to be attending, so you'll be able to reminisce with more people than me. We intend, we're not going to wait another 10 years before we have another get together. We certainly have one within the next. Exactly. Yeah. So we certainly are going to do something maybe in the next 5 years, and you'll have a chance to meet hopefully all of the people that were at the 50th. And listen, thanks very much, Doug. I'm not able to hold this camera very much longer. My arms beginning to shake. Billy was right, I should have got a tripod.
Was inclined to roam. Here of the
Gay, 50 years ago, we both went to this great institution, Wesley College. What have you been doing all these years?
Well, that's a bit of a long story.
Yeah, but keep it as short as you can.
Yeah, dominated by work, family, and travel. So I've lived in many countries. I've had two boys with my Australian husband. I worked for 12 years in Melbourne at a university, recruiting international students all through Asia. Now I'm retired. I keep saying I because my husband lives mostly in Asia and we kind of go between the two. I'm living at the moment in Tasmania, but I spend most of my time now either in Asia or in Europe because that's where the two sons are with the grandchildren. And we're going there now for 6 weeks for Christmas. And then after that, we're moving back to Melbourne.
Now tell me, do you ever think about your days at Wesley?
Sometimes, particularly when I talk to Gwenda or email Gwenda Saul in New York, Rhode Island. Mm-hmm. Also, when I go back to England every year, I go to visit, obviously, my sister, and she is still in touch with a girl called Jenny McGregor, who was in her year at Wesley. So, and Melody Green was actually there this time, who was the year above us. So, yes, and then we have wonderful tales about what happened in the boarding house at Wesley.
So why don't you share one of those tales with me now?
Right, well, Melody and I this last time were talking about when we were in Epworth Hall and we had a hockey, well, she was a sort of boarding student person called Hilary Darcy, or Hilary DeLacy.
DeLacy, she was a hockey star, wasn't
that's
she?
That's it, and Melody and I both played hockey as well. And she always had these boyfriends who used to deliver her back at midnight in racy sports cars. And Melody and I were just saying how we used to lie there in bed and think, oh, isn't she lucky?
You're dreaming of your future.
But anyway, so that was one of the tales, yes.
I see. When you think about your days at Wesley, what is it that comes to mind?
Enjoyment. I mostly enjoyed my time at Wesley. I was in Tullamarine and I was also in Epworth and I enjoyed it all. I enjoyed being with other girls mostly. I enjoyed the film nights when we got a bit older, when we waited for the lights to go off and there was all this scattering in
That's
all directions.
Right. And the passing of notes from the boys to the girls.
Exactly. all of that innocent, compared to today, very innocent playing and enjoyment and laughing. And yes, it was hard work. And yes, you could say, well, it could be lonely. But I was never lonely because I enjoyed the company of the other of other people. So, you know, I remember arriving from England at some ridiculous hour in the morning with my sister, which meant that we could bag the best beds because nobody else was going to come.
Was an Irish expression. that was an Irish expression you used just now. Bags the best beds.
Yes.
Do you remember the food at Wesley and at Epworth?
Awful. Awful.
Describe it.
Well, what I remember is whatever day it was that we had Irish stew at the main college, and it was just, for me, it would put me off any kind of stew or casserole for life. It took me forever until I was about 40 before I could actually take a piece of meat that size that had been cooked in gravy or something and put it in my mouth. It just wouldn't go down.
What about the porridge?
Porridge? I like porridge. I still like porridge. No, I liked the porridge then and I like it now.
And do you know that in Wesley today, they have like a cafeteria with several different choices of food, and they have fish and chicken and chips and beans and you name it.
Yeah, well, very nice for them. I remember at the in the main college that we used to have some sort of soup thing, and we at the end of the sort of course you had to pass the bowls down the table, and by the time they got to the end of the table it was all overflowing. Because hardly anybody had eaten any of it. But by that time the teacher couldn't tell who it belonged to, so no.
Do you remember any of the teachers? Do you remember any of your teachers?
Yes, I remember. What was the Gaelic teacher's name? Was Mr. the guy he
Paul Hanrahan.
Was he the one who kicked the used to kick the duster at people?
No. Rocky O'Hanrahan was a very, very nice fellow. He never did that. Maybe you're thinking of Sam McGee.
I am. No, Sam McGee was the very
was it Brosnan? Mr. Brosnan.
Billy, I can't remember, but lots of people in that class will remember because he kicked dusters, he threw chalk. He wasn't nasty particularly, but that was his way of having a go. Yeah.
What did you think of the boys at Wesley?
I can remember, and I get the two schools mixed up as well, you know, because I went on to another school.
Yeah.
But I can remember a day, was it a David Alford?
That's right.
And was there a McIlwain?
Ken McIlwain. David Alford lives in Canada, and he has also done an interview for this film, so you'll be able to see him. And Ken McIlwain... Right. David Alford's father was the school dentist in Harcourt Street.
Yeah.
And Ken McIlwain is David Alford's cousin. And he was captain of the rugby team.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure. I mean, the thing is, because I left so early, you've got to remember, the boys had hardly reached puberty. So there's not a memorable impression, really.
Okay, so look, this film hopefully will be seen by people in the future because it'll be put in the Wesley archives. And if you could speak with people who are going to look at this maybe in 50 years from now to see how we lived in the mid-19th century, what would you like to say to them about your days at Wesley?
That going to a boarding school can be overwhelming. However, if you take it all on board and enjoy what you can and have a little cry if you have to, it can be fantastic and you'll make lots of friends.
Yeah, that's the thing. I think we formed a lot of bonds, didn't we?
Yeah.
Like I could tell talking to Gwenda that she had a sort of bond with you.
That's right. Well, we were, as you might call it nowadays, besties.
Yeah. I understand that you're living in Tasmania, and a lot of us Wesley boys used to go to the Grafton cinema and watch the cartoons when we were at Wesley. And there was a cartoon figure called the Tasmanian Devil. So maybe you can tell me, does he exist?
Well, he doesn't exist, but it exists. It's a little animal, very, very ugly.
That goes round and round in circles, right?
Sort of, yes. Yeah. And that's the Tasmanian Devil. I know people don't. And when people come here from overseas, everybody says, can we see the Tasmanian Devil? And so you take them there. It's quite often disappointed because it is actually quite small and very fierce. They're very fierce animals with big teeth.
Really? And they're actually called Tasmanian Devils?
Yeah. Yeah, that is its species. I mean, I'm sure it's got a Latin name, but I think it's its species.
He was too young to fall in love. I was too young to know. Why did I give my heart so fast? Never will happen again. I was a young lad of 16. My first year since then.
She was too young to fall in love. I was too young to know. She was only 16, only 16. I loved her so, but she was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know. We'd laugh and we'd sing and do the little things that made my heart glow. But she was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know. Why did I give my heart so fast? It never will happen again. But I was a mere lad of 16. I've aged a year since then. She was on the 16, on the 16, with eyes that would glow. But she was 16, too young to fall 16, in love, and I was too young to know.
Then why did you give your heart so fast?
Boy, it never will happen again.
But you were a mere lad of 16.
I've aged a year since then. She was on the 16, on the 16, with eyes that would glow. But she was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know. But she was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know. Oh, she's 16 to fall.
Terry, 50 years, where have you been all this time?
I've been in Canada for all that time, Billy, ever since I left in 1969.
So I've lived in British Columbia. You emigrated in 1969?
That's correct.
Okay. And tell us a little bit about your life, because a lot of people were asking about you at the 50th and at the 40th. And very few people seem to know, you know, where you were. Where you were, I think many people knew, but we didn't know what you were doing. So how has life treated you?
Oh, life's been pretty good. When I left Ireland England in 1969, I came to Canada for ostensibly 2 years. After about being here for 3 or 4 months, I decided this is where I was going to stay. So we've been in British Columbia ever since that time. And I was, because when I arrived, I had very little money and no job. I got a job within 3 days of landing in Toronto. The job was in Victoria, British Columbia, and the company paid me to come out here, and that's where I stayed.
And you're not very far from David Alford.
No, he's just about 3 hours up the road here, actually, on Vancouver Island. Mind you, having said that, I haven't seen him for a few years.
And have you been back to Ireland since? Or have you been very often back?
I don't have a direct family in Ireland. They're all in England. So anytime I go back, it's usually to the UK. So I did go to Ireland in 2006, and we did a bit of traveling around.
Yeah.
Stayed with Gordon Milne and just saw a bit of Ireland, and then that was it. I haven't been back since then.
And your wife is Canadian?
She is, yes.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah, Rosemary's Canadian.
Okay. Now tell me, Terry, do you ever think about your days at Wesley?
Not very often, I'm glad to say.
Glad to say? How would you sum up your... Well, first of all, let me get this straight. Which year did you start at Wesley?
I think it was 59.
And you left in 63 with the rest of us.
63, yeah.
You did your leaving certificate. So, if you were to sum up those years at Wesley, how would you describe them?
As far as boarding school goes, actually was, you know, I look back, it wasn't too bad, to be honest. I had a lot of fun. Mind you, there was an awful lot of boredom, as you probably remember yourself.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, but, you know, I like the people there, and, you know, you can make the best of what you have.
What about the food? Do you remember the food?
Ah, many times I think of the food, yeah. It's one reason I left Ireland.
The porridge. Do you remember the porridge?
Well, there's things like rissoles too, and...
Oh, yes, the rissoles are nice, yeah.
Those delicacies.
That's right,
yeah.
And have you ever been to see the old, the new school, I mean? Because the old school is gone.
No, I've never been up there. I've never been to the new school.
It's funny, we were talking about the other day that most of us have been there, but we just don't feel, it doesn't feel like being at Wesley.
Well, that's right, yeah. The times that I was in Ireland, I had to look at the old place where I actually did go to school.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what
the railings
it's like
are still there. Did you notice that the railing is still there? The sign, the Wesley sign, is gone, but the railing is still there.
Is that right? No, I don't remember that.
And I was I went up to Bloomfield a few years ago, and I was thinking that poor old Morrison would have got a fit if he saw that there was a little tree growing right in the middle of his cricket pitch.
Oh.
Do you remember that?
Yeah, that's another thing I wasn't very happy about, was playing rugby in the cold and rain of the winter.
Yeah. Who was it? John McMullen was saying something about, he remembered how the two of you went over to England on the Munster or the Leinster or the boat.
That's right, the B&I line. I remember going over there. Well, I used to go over and back all the time.
Yeah, because your family was in England, weren't they?
They were in England, yeah.
Yeah.
My brother was 2 years older. He was in sixth form when I was in fourth form.
I see. Well, now tell me, what do you think about the fact that Wesley is now interdenominational? Like in our day, it was Protestant and a few Jews. But now there's Catholics there and Muslims and you name it. What do you think about that?
I think it's a great idea.
It's progress, right?
Oh, absolutely. You know, I over here it's a very mixed society.
Yeah.
We've got people from all over the world over in, you know, Vancouver. It's totally interracial.
Oh yeah, I know. There are a lot of. It's a very multiracial society in Canada.
Yeah.
But Ireland has become like that too, because.
And I noticed that there's a heck of a lot of. People who aren't Irish there.
Polish people.
Exactly.
Lithuanians and Latvians and you name it. So, Terry, what I'd really like you to do is to say a few words to, because everybody was asking about you at the 50th. So here's your chance. Everybody's going to see this. So you can mention people if you want to. I'll put the camera, I'll leave the floor to you. Go ahead. You're talking to your mates now.
Well, I'd just like to say hello to all the people that I might have seen had I been over in Wesley in October, I think it was, recently.
Yeah, 5th of October.
I had intended to go, but at the last minute, things didn't pan out, so I didn't get there. If there's a 68th anniversary, then perhaps I'll be there. I sure hope I'll be around at that time.
You'll be very welcome.
Yeah.
And tell me, do you have you had any contact with anybody from Wesley over these years?
I keep in contact with Gordon Milne.
Yeah, okay.
And we do correspond, usually at Christmas.
Yeah, okay.
Most of the other people, of course, are from engineering school in Trinity.
Yeah. And Terry, what was the best thing about going to Wesley when you look back on it?
Well, there was some academic stuff that I quite liked. You know, believe it or not, I enjoyed Mr. Kirkpatrick, and I always enjoyed his lessons, in particularly English literature.
Mm-hmm.
So there were some good things about it. Learned something, obviously.
Do you have any special memories, like, of, because you were a boarder, just like myself.
Right.
Do you have any special memories of Sam McGee or Pig Morrison or anybody like that?
Oh, well, I remember, I think it was one time. Bert, do you remember when we were making that ginger beer?
Oh, yes.
And we had a dorm feast one night. We were drinking ginger beer. And I think it was Mr. Milner came along as we were having our feast, or at least we had scuttled back to bed afterwards, and he said something along the lines of, "Do I smell beer in here?" And someone said, it might have been you, in fact, someone said, "Well, Mr. Morrison has just been in here."
That was probably me. You know that we did meet a guy, Milner.
Is that right?
Yes, he came to one of the reunions in London a couple of years ago, and he looked exactly the same and spoke exactly the same. It was very nice to see him. Terry, tell me just one more thing. If you could talk to people who were going to attend Wesley in the future, what would you say to them? Like, for example, I was thinking that when we were at school, it would have been incredible if we could have seen how people at Wesley lived maybe 50 years or 100 years before our time, but the technology wasn't there. The technology is there today, and this film is going into the archives at Wesley, and maybe in 50 years' time somebody's going to look at it, who knows. What would you like them to know from Terry Coulter?
Well, you know, I have to say, I enjoyed my time at Wesley. Despite the boring parts of it, but we did have a good grounding in academics, and I think it was a good place to be at the time.
And we were quite good kids, weren't we, when you think about it?
Well, we had a good time together. You must admit there weren't very many people at the school, so we got to know just about everyone.
We did, yeah. We formed a lot of bonds, didn't we?
Yeah.
And that was something that was very visible at the 50th celebration, how people met each other for the first time in decades, and it was as if they'd known each other the day before, you know, it was incredible.
That's right.
Really.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, okay, Terry, just a farewell word to all your classmates, and they're not very happy with this little interview.
Well, I'd just like to say, I'm sorry I didn't see you all in October, and perhaps I'll see you again another time.
I don't care just what they say, just so long as you will stay. You and I will be as free as the birds up in the trees.
Diana Holmes, this is for you.
I'm so young and you're so old. This, my darling, I've been told. I don't care just what they say, 'cause forever I will pray. You and I will be as free as the birds up in the trees. Oh, please stay by me, Diana. I love you, but do you love me? Oh, Diana, can't you see? I love you with all my heart, and I hope we will never part. Oh, please stay with me, Diana.
Maisie, 53 years ago, you left Wesley College when you and I were in third form. And I haven't seen you since. And I think some of the people from our year at Wesley have met you at one of the reunions. Tell me a little bit about your life, what you've been doing.
Gosh, it's been one very busy life until we retired about 10 years ago, and I really switched from a busy, crazy, something happening every day to a life of really calmness and where I can study meditation and yoga, and it's a total difference.
And you've been in the fashion industry, right?
Yes, I was in the fashion industry in many parts. I had a model agency, a school. We recruited people as well for occupations. We handled photographers, makeup artists.
But you also organized something.
International models.
But you also organized something which was very well known in New Zealand. What was that?
That was the New Zealand Fashion Awards. It was a televised event that I did for 16 years. It was a huge event with 70 camera crew, so you can imagine what that takes. And it was really the culmination of all I ever wanted to do. I was involved with fashion promotions from about 5 years after I started the agency. And that really took over my life. The other just sort of kept running along, but the actual event coordination was what I really enjoyed.
Now tell me, during these years that you've been in New Zealand, have you ever thought about your time at Wesley College?
I can't say I'm a person who looks backwards terribly often, but when I do look back, yes, I look back and I think they were very formative years for me. I was very grateful for the discipline that I learned at Wesley. I felt I had some great tutors. Miss Cook, to name one, I'm sure some of the girls from my era will remember her name. I thought she was wonderful and very inspiring and just a great role model.
Do you remember that we used to save up money, our pennies from our pocket money, and buy and she used to go out and buy paintings? Remember?
Well, I remember her taking us to an art gallery one Saturday afternoon, and we all had to go back to Tullamaine and write a story on one of the paintings
that
we saw. Now, I was probably right down the bottom of the class, but for some reason that day, something inspired me, and she gave me first prize, which I'll never forget because it gave me such a boost of confidence.
It sure did.
A surprise to everybody in the school.
And you were in Tullamaine. You were at Tullamaine, right?
Yes.
Do you have any little anecdote from there that you remember? Do you remember anything about the food or the dormitories, or is there anything you remember?
Yes, I remember actually, as you bring these things up, of course I remember them. One particular instance, I was learning to play the piano. Again, not a very good student in that area. Didn't sort of stick at it for terribly long. But I was practicing in the reception room, and Miss Smith came in and she said, Maisie, you continue practicing. We've got some very important visitors. And they arrived, and I was very embarrassed because I couldn't play anything, but I did remember that I could play the chopsticks. So I was banging away at the piano playing chopsticks, and I don't think anyone was very impressed. I think I got wrapped over the knuckles for that one and told no, that was not her work.
Can you play chopsticks today?
I probably could if you put a piano in front of me, but gosh, I haven't sat down in front of a piano for many, many years, probably since then actually.
So do you think that the years you spent at Wesley College have had any kind of effect on your life, on your adult life?
Oh, I could never have juggled the businesses and kept my lifestyle up without true organisation. And I think I was really taught that. And again, the discipline of work. You know, it's
the basic standards.
I would finish until the job was done, and I would work as long as I needed to get it done properly.
Amazing. You know what I remember about you? I remember you were fashion conscious already at that age, because I remember that we boys used to sit at 1B, the window. Do you remember the classroom 1B? It was facing the front of the school, and we'd sit at the window watching all the girls walking up through the steps from the gymnasium where they were downstairs, and you would go up and you would walk out through the school, and we would be all sitting waiting for you and Diana Holmes because you both had the best legs because you were wearing the seamless stockings. Do you remember when the seamless stockings came?
Yes, yes. I'm totally unconscious of that, Billy.
Well, there you are. Because
I think what we did have at Wesley back in those days was a proper childhood, you know, yes, and yes. I guess we were too busy being silly little girls and not really thinking about stuff like that.
Do you remember any people from that time?
Oh yes, of course. Diana Holmes, who was pretty much one of my best friends. Yes. She was called Minnie Mouse and I was called Mighty Mouse, and we went everywhere together. We're a little bit different in heights there. Margaret Warren. Look, there were just many people, a lot of faces that I can remember.
Arthur Ennis?
Yes, I do. He was very, very funny in class.
And you know that he passed away. You know that he passed away at the age of 29?
No, really?
He had a heart attack in the 70s at the age of 29.
Well, I'm very sorry to hear that.
Yeah, that was very, very sad. Yeah, very sad. Anyway, Maisie, what would you like? Would you like to say something short to, because there are a lot of people who remember you, so the camera is yours. Say a few words to some of your old classmates from a long time ago.
Well, just thank you for putting up with me, really. I have good memories of Wesley, but I was happy to leave. It was time to move on as far as I was concerned. I've had the most amazing life. I've done things I never expected I would be able to do. I've done a lot of travelling. And it's a shame that we haven't been able to keep in touch with everybody. But that is life. It moves on. And I've moved on. I'm in a different space now. I'm really happy where I am, and I think it's because I was able to do a lot of what was inside of me. I got it done, got it out, and I'm able to see up the other side now. I do hope that you're all having a wonderful life, and I'm sorry I wasn't able to be at the reunion.
Well, let's hope you're able to come to the 60th.
When
the 60th will be in 10 years from now.
Oh my goodness. Okay. Yes. Well, I guess we'll still be traveling.
Let's keep our fingers crossed, okay? Right. Thank you very much, Maisie. Thank you.
Thank you.
You can dance every dance with the guy who gives you the eye to let him hold you tight. You can smile every smile for the man who held your hand beneath the pale moonlight. But don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. So darling, say the last dance for me. Oh, I know that the music's fine like sparkling wine. Go and have your fun. Oh, I know. Laugh and sing, yes, I know. But while we're apart, don't give your heart to anyone. But don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. So darling, say the last dance for me. Baby, don't you know I love you so? Can't you feel it when we touch? I will never, never let you go. I love you oh so much. You can dance,
you can dance.
Go and carry you on dance. Till the night is gone
dance.
And it's time to
you
go.
You can dance.
If he asks,
you can dance.
If you're all alone,
you can
he take you,
you
home?
Dance.
You must tell him
you
no.
Dance.
Cause don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. So darling, say the last dance for me. Cause don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. So darling, say the last dance for me. Say the last dance for me. Say the last.
Mr. Stéophane O'Hanrahan, it's wonderful to have you in this film about the class of 1963. Do you remember the class of 1963?
I do indeed, because it was the class that I finished up with in Wesley. It was my last year in Wesley. And, you know, there was a sense in which I missed that particular class, and indeed the wonderful qualities of all the youngsters that I taught in Wesley.
But I think you helped to shape some of those youngsters, didn't you?
Well,
with your good example.
One would hope so. I remember your mentioning my wearing a particular pin on my
That's right, you
jacket.
Had a teetotaler's pin, didn't you?
That is correct.
I remember that. I remember that.
And I remember you saying to me that that had an effect on quite a number of people.
Oh, it did indeed. It did indeed.
Right.
Well, now tell me something. Do you remember what we used to call you?
Rocky.
And do you know where that came from?
Well, I think it was a fainting or something like that.
You know what it was? It was that when you started at Wesley, it was at this round about that time when Rocky Marciano was a very famous boxer, and you looked a little bit like him. So that's where you got the name.
Oh, was it?
But anyway, tell me something. How was it teaching us Irish? Because a lot of us were not very good at it.
Well, again, I think I would have to say that never troubled me too much. I think you brought students from the state they were in as far as you could. The wonderful qualities of the youngsters themselves, their discipline, their enthusiasm, their friendliness, very often helped
to get them to learn.
But do you think
it's strange that somebody like myself, for example, now I'm turning 68 in a few weeks from now, and I still remember the poems like Mishraftrian Philalan Dokishis Gro, Kodienamid Fashtaganaim Toderana Gircher Law, Hornig Long of Valparaiso. How come I still remember that? You must have had a big impression on me for me
and
to remember that.
And do you remember Anishis Trollum Parley?
Oh, indeed I do. And you know what? There have been many times in my life when I was close to death. Once was when I had a heart attack a few years ago, and the first thing that came into my head was Anishis Trollum Parley Yena Fastaladia.
Good man.
But you know what? The one thing that we all hated, and I don't know if you loved it or if you hated it, was that terrible book that we had for the Leaving Cert.
Oh, yes, it was ridiculous. Do
you remember that?
It was ridiculous. We didn't have any jurisdiction over what was put every third year, but it was ridiculous.
And we had.
I think the one you loved was Brian Og.
Do you remember the centipedes? The Hill Cussing.
Or the sense that you just
and I remember, said. I remember how you explained that to us. You said, you said the Hill Cussing, Hill is 1,000 and Cussing is feet. And so it's 1,000 feet. And that's how I remembered it anyway.
Very good.
And you know, you mentioned Brian Og just now. Well, it might surprise you. Do you want to know exactly what you wrote on the blackboard? Because I remember it off by heart. Do you want to hear it? What you wrote on the blackboard. This is what you wrote. Vi Brian Og O'Dolig I Gloshtan a Gael Shadyag Shaskas a Chuig Aber Sagart a Vi Aun Ok Vi Fun Ogla Saidurik Ta Air. Now, do you remember that?
My goodness. My goodness. That's very, very good. Very close to it, I'd say.
I must have been listening in your class. tell me, Stéophane, do you remember any of the names of any of the people in 63? Like, for example, we had Gwenda Saul. Do you remember Gwenda?
Yes.
And the Coen twins. Remember the Coen twins?
The
Julie and Ida Coen.
Oh, yes, indeed.
Yes,
and
they remember
I've met those. Are they in the States all the time?
They're in the States, yes.
Yeah.
And also, many people remember you. Stuart Matthews, David Greer.
Oh, yes.
There were Alison Galbraith. Everybody, right. Everybody remembers you. Now, tell me something. What do you think was the best thing about working as a teacher at Wesley in the early 60s?
Oh, it was the quality of the students. Their enthusiasm, their friendliness, and a fair amount of ability. Remember. Now, you had the help of music. You were putting tunes to,
right.
If I remember,
that's
and
right.
Learning that way.
That's
but
right.
Many of them did quite well. By the way, is my memory of Greer is Australia.
That's right, David Greer. He lives in Australia, and
right.
his brother Robert lives in Glenageary.
All right.
In Dublin.
Very good.
But now...
Was there an Eleanor Knott? Or?
There was a Brian Knott.
Brian, yeah. Now,
Brian
one of the
Knott.
Girls...
That's
one of the girls... One of the girls called Knott, no?
No, there wasn't a girl called Knott. There was a boy, Brian Knott.
Brian Knott, yes.
Yeah. And you remember Arthur Ennis, I'm sure?
Of course.
And
Arthur Ennis was Castle up in County Cavan or somewhere.
That's right, Ballyconnell. His
Ballyconnell.
Father owned the milling company in Ballyconnell.
Yes.
And
that's
then
right.
There was John McMullen. Do you remember John McMullen?
John McMullen was south, I think. John McMullen. He had a sister as well in the school.
That's right. And John McMullen, his father was running the cable station in Waterville.
Oh yes, is that right?
Yeah.
Now, as I say, I would have placed him for south, all right.
Yeah. And do you remember Roy McKeever, Shine McKeever? We used to call him Shine.
Shine McKeever.
Do you remember him? Or maybe that was before. Which year did you start at Wesley?
I started at Christmas, about five years before.
About 58.
Before I left.
About 58,
there was
59.
There was a Mr. Would it be Mr. Peters in Wesley?
That's right.
I had been teaching for in high school.
Yeah.
Around the corner.
Yeah.
And Mr. Peters was going there at Christmas. I said, well, if I prove myself here, would there be an exchange in order? So, seemingly, they found something good with me in
now
high school.
Me,
and
tell me something.
Recommend.
Do you remember the fact that you being a Roman Catholic, working at a Methodist school, that school has now become a multi-denominational, so that nowadays you have all kinds of religions at Wesley, and there are facilities for the spiritual needs of Catholics, Protestants, you name it, Muslims,
right.
You know. And what
right.
do you think about that?
Right. Well, that's very good.
It's a good progress, isn't it?
I remember being at some, I forget, was it a funeral? And someone else and myself, was there a Dinny Brosnan there?
That's right, there was a Brosnan, yeah.
We were waiting outside the church, the little church, until the funeral came out. And it was then we could join it.
Yeah.
That was the days. They were dark days.
They were, in that sense. Yeah.
Have you ever been
past the old school,
yes.
Stephen's Green? And what are your thoughts when you go past there?
Sadness.
Sadness
that the building is gone.
Yeah.
Sadness that, well, definitely, I suppose, sadness for old times. What cheers one has, the good memories one has of it.
Yeah. And tell me one thing now, finally. I'd like you to say a few words to all the people who are going to be watching this film, and they are all your former pupils who are going to be listening to this. So I'm going to let you talk, and if you remember any of the names, you can address them. But I'd just like you to say a few words to them now.
It's great to talk to you and to think of the class of about 63 again, and to think of all the students that went that I taught in Wesley. I have the highest respect, the highest regard for Wesley College. And when I pass it, I'm certainly full of memories.
And you know, Stefan, I'll tell you something. We all feel the same about you.
Well, that's great to hear.
The feeling is absolutely mutual. I think I can speak for the rest of the class of 63 that you were one of the most appreciated teachers that we had. You're very welcome. And so, Garamahagat, and I look forward to seeing you when I come to Dublin.
That will be great.
Take care of yourself, and I'll send you a copy of this film.
Thank you very much. Garamila Mahagat, Billy.
Okay. Slán lát. Slán.
Just you know why you and I will by and by know true love ways. Sometimes we'll sigh, sometimes we'll cry, and we'll know why. Just you and I know true love why. Throughout the day, our true love ways will bring us joys to share with those who really care. Sometimes we'll sigh, sometimes we'll cry, and we'll know why. Just you and I.
cathedral bells were tolling, and our hearts sang on. Was it the spell of Paris or the April dawn? Who knows if we shall meet again? But when the morning chimes ring sweet again, in all the old familiar places that this heart of mine embraces all day through. In that small cafe, the park across the way, the children's carousel, the chestnut tree, the wishing well, I'll be seeing you in every lovely summer's day, in everything that's light and gay. I'll always think of you that way. I'll find you in the morning sun, and when the night is new, I'll be looking at the moon, but I'll be seeing you. But I'll be seeing.